In this video, we're continuing on with our special right triangles worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Infinite Geometry tab. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, picking up with number 13, we have to remember the ratios for 45-45-90 degree triangles and 30-60-90 triangles. In a 45-45-90, our ratio is 1 to 1 to the square root of 2. And we can write that as x, x, and the square root of 2, x. So in this case, u is equal to x, and v is equal to x. And 8 times the square root of 2 is equal to the square root of 2 times x. So we'll solve for x, and then plug it in for our missing side lengths. Dividing by the square root of 2, we'll get that 8 is equal to x. So u is equal to 8, and v is equal to 8. We have a 30-60-90 triangle. Across from 90 degrees, we'll have 2z. Across from 30 degrees is 1z, or z. And across from 60 degrees is the square root of 3 times z. So y is equal to z, and x is equal to 2z. Now let's solve for z, given that the square root of 3 times z is equal to 12. So we're going to divide by the square root of 3. So we have that z is equal to 12 over the square root of 3. But we want to write 12 in a different manner so that we can cancel out the square root of 3 in our denominator. So in our denominator, we'll still have square root of 3, but let's write 12 instead as 4 times 3. And 4 times 3 we can write as 4 times the square root of 3 times the square root of 3. So go ahead and type this into your calculator. 4 times the square root of 3 times the square root of 3 is going to be 4 times 3, which is 12. But if we write 12 as 4 times the square root of 3 times the square root of 3, one of those square root of 3s will cancel out and give us that z is equal to 4 times the square root of 3. Now we'll be able to plug this in for z in our equations above. So y is equal to z. So y is 4 times the square root of 3, and x is equal to 2 times z, so 2 times 4 times the square root of 3. So x is equal to 2 times 4 times the square root of 3, which is 8 times the square root of 3. So y is 4 times the square root of 3, and x is 8 times the square root of 3. So remember, just because you're given a number, rearranging or rewriting that number may help you solve a problem. Just be sure not to change the value of that number. In number 15, we have another 30, 60, 90. Across from 90 is going to be 2x. Across from 60 is the square root of 3 times x. And across from 30 is x. So b is equal to x, and a is equal to the square root of 3 times x. All we need to do is divide by 2 to get that 3 halves is equal to x. So now we'll plug 3 halves in for x. So b is equal to x, which is 3 halves, and a will be equal to 3 halves times the square root of 3, which is 3 times the square root of 3 over 2. B, our missing side, is 3 halves, and a, our other missing side, is 3 times the square root of 3 over 2. And number 16, another 30, 60, 90. Across from 30, x. Across from 90, 2x. And across from 60 is the square root of 3 times x. So let's solve for x. 11 times the square root of 3 is equal to the square root of 3 times x. So all we need to do is divide by the square root of 3, and that will cancel itself out. Square root of 3 divided by square root of 3 is 1. And 11 squared root of 3 divided by the square root of 3 is 11. So 11 is equivalent to x. So for a, if a is equal to 2x, then a is going to be equal to 2 times 11, which is 22. And if b is equal to x, then b is going to be 11. So we have a is 22 and b is 11 in number 16. In number 17, another 30, 60, 90. Across from 60 is the square root of 3 times x. across from 30 is going to be x, and across from 90 is going to be 2x. So if 2x equals 2 times the square root of 2, dividing by 2 will give us that x is equal to the square root of 2. So a equals the square root of 3 times x. So a equals the square root of 3 times x, which is the square root of 2. So that's going to be a equal to the square root of 3 times 2. So a is equal to the square root of 6. And if b is equal to x, then b is equal to the square root of 2. A is the square root of 6, and b is the square root of 2. And lastly, for this video, number 18. Before I solve this 45-45-90 triangle, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now, seeing that we have a 45-45-90, we can write the ratios as x, x, and the square root of 2 times x. So if 7 equals the square root of 2 times x, when we divide by the square root of 2, we'll get that 7 over the square root of 2 is equal to x. So in order to get this radical out of the denominator, why don't we just multiply this value by 1? Multiplying any number by 1 doesn't change the original value. And let's make that 1 the square root of 2 over the square root of 2. So x is going to be equal to 7 times the square root of 2 over square root of 2 times the square root of 2 is 2. So I'm multiplying my numerators, and then I'm multiplying my denominators. That is equal to x. And x is equal to both n and m. So m equals 7 square root of 2 over 2, and n equals 7 square root of 2 over 2. And with that, we finish up this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.